Now, every team needs some West Indian flair, and there were lots of West Indians at the IPL auction, the likes of Nicholas Pooran and Shimron Hetmeyer. They have CPL experience in the past, so they're very up to grips with the format. It's going to be exciting IPL with their involvement, isn't it?
Yes, and also the West Indies players will be involved for the entire duration of the IPL, you would assume, because a lot of these players will perhaps not feature in the plans for the West Indies in the World Cup that will follow. Because the West Indies is now seen as this factory of producing really skilled T20 players, we keep getting glimpses of them, not just in the CPL, Suyash, but think back to the India West Indies limited over series where Hetmeyer made such a big impression. Also think of guys like O'Shane Thomas, quick bowler who got Shikhar Dhawan out a few times. All of this would not have gone unnoticed, and the fact that these islands are producing players who are very skilled at the T20 game means that these young players keep getting bids. There was another one, Rutherford, who's got a very substantial bid on the basis of what is clearly T20 hitting ability.
Right. Of course, what does this mean for the West Indies national team, though? Because, as you said, they might not get picked for the World Cup squads. That's a bit of a pity, isn't it?
It might be, yes, Suyash, but I think that the West Indies is now almost the sort of home of this factory line or this assembly line of production of T20 cricketers. And that is being spotted by teams around the world in T20 leagues, because these players are available to play and they offer very compelling skill sets. Obviously, these players are also part of existing franchises. You can go through the list, Bravo and Pollard and players of this kind, but they keep producing these young players who have now been identified at this auction that we saw today. And every time one of these guys came up for bidding, they were quite aggressively sought for. It also helps that some of these teams are in ways involved in the CPL, so they see them at very close quarters, and that's resulted in these West Indian players getting the bids that they have.
Well, we can just hope that they light up the IPL like only West Indian players can.